In its 2015 progress report, the European Union criticized Turkey for its human rights abuses and breaches in democracy. This could pose a problem for Turkey, which has been trying to join the European Economic Community since 1987. But the Turkish government's autocratic and severe rule of law has only worsened, leaving the country further away from its goal. This left us wondering, will Turkey ever be able to join the EU? Well, to qualify for EU membership, a country must have a stable democracy, a functioning economy, and a government that only acts within its rule of law. EU applicants must also respect their citizens' human rights and protect minority groups. Any European nation can apply to the EU, but if they don't meet these standards, they will likely remain a candidate country. Turkey and several other countries fall into this category, meaning they are routinely reviewed to assess their eligibility. The United States and the United Kingdom have long supported Turkey's accession into the EU. However, German Chancellor Angela Merkel, arguably one of the most powerful leaders in Europe, has historically opposed their potential entry. But regardless of their alliances, Turkey is far from meeting the EU's conditions for entry. Although their president, Recep Tayyip Erdogan, was democratically elected, the country is hardly a true democracy. Turkey ranks near the bottom of the 2015 Reporters Without Borders Press Freedom Index, and in just 18 months, nearly 2,000 legal cases were opened for insulting Erdogan. Erdogan controls most of Turkey's free press and has reportedly threatened, arrested, and even killed journalists who oppose him or his party. In March 2016, Turkish courts authorized police to oust the editors of the country's leading opposition newspaper. Many censored journalists and civilians are part of Turkey's Kurdish minority, which have long faced legal discrimination and violence in the country. Erdogan's military has carried out attacks on ethnic Kurds in southeast Turkey in the name of fighting the Kurdish separatist group, the PKK. Turkey ended a two-year ceasefire with the PKK in July 2015. Since hostilities were resumed, hundreds of Kurdish civilians have been killed and many left without food, water, and electricity. But despite their assaults on Kurdish civilians and worsening treatment of the press, Turkey may actually have a shot at joining the European Union. This is because the Turkish government has agreed to readmit hundreds of thousands of migrants who had passed through the country on their way to Greece and Western Europe. In return, Turkey is demanding more than $6 billion of EU support, as well as visa-free travel for Turks and a faster path to EU membership. European leaders are desperate for Turkey's cooperation in the worst refugee crisis since World War II. So even though Turkey doesn't fulfill most of the EU's membership requirements, they do have one major bargaining chip, the refugee crisis. Whether this will leverage them into the EU despite Erdogan's authoritarian regime is yet to be seen. The EU member states aren't the only ones displeased with Erdogan's behavior. Turkish citizens themselves have been rebelling against the president for years. To find out why Turkey hates its president, check out this video above. Or, to learn why three Turkish cities dominate the list of fastest developing cities, check out this video below. Thanks for watching Test Tube News, everyone. Don't forget to like and subscribe so you get new videos from us every day.